been digging far back into Trump's business dealings and his family and his associates.
So, Shimon, stick around with me because I'm going to depend on your reporting on some of this. But also adding to the conversation with us is Asha Rangappa is here. She's a CNN legal and national security analyst and former FBI special agent. And Mimi Rocha, a former federal prosecutor. Mimi, before I get to anything else, I wanted to ask you first about Donald Trump's kind of response to all of this, if you will. Part of his response, it gets to his tweet, which is, it would seem very hard to obstruct justice for a crime that never happened, witch hunt. How does this fit into the legal definition of obstruction? That's been a big part of the conversation this morning.
That is inaccurate, what he's saying there. You absolutely can obstruct a crime that never occurred. The way that it works is, you know, somebody can think that they've done something wrong, illegal or just wrong, that they don't want people to find out about. The question is not whether there's an underlying crime that actually was committed. The question is whether there's a crime that was being investigated. And in this case, that's very clear. I mean, we've had this investigation going on. Sometimes, you know, you'll have a case where it's not quite so clear that there was an actual sort of FBI investigation. That's crystal clear here. So it's really about, was there an investigation going on? And did the person try to obstruct, to impede, to delay? Mm-hmm. You know, there's all sorts of different verbs you can use. So his tweet is absolutely incorrect. You know, I think we don't know here yet. It's also incorrect as a factual matter because we have absolutely no idea whether there is an underlying crime yet. In fact, these questions, which are very telling even without the answers, seem to suggest that Mueller thinks at least some people are committing crimes. But as a legal matter, it's also incorrect that you cannot obstruct an investigation where no crime was committed.
Asha, let me ask about this one. Asking about outreach from Paul Manafort, which I mentioned up at top, Paul Manafort to Russia for potential assistance to the campaign. So far, there hasn't been anything really reported about Manafort reaching out to Russia for help. To you, does this mean that Mueller has something there, or could they simply just be asking because Manafort's in a whole bunch of other trouble?
Well, a pretty basic rule of interviews like this is that you already know the answers to the questions that you're going in to ask. You still ask them in an open-ended way so the person can give their own version of it. But I suspect that they probably have some evidence of coordination between Manafort and Russia. I mean, this only makes sense in terms of what we already know about Manafort, who was a subject of two FISA orders, which you can only get if you know that if you can show a court that the person was acting knowingly on behalf of a foreign intelligence service. So we know that they have some evidence there already. The question is, was he doing any of that while he's in the campaign? And it is definitely a question that goes directly to the heart of a collusion of direct assistance being solicited from Russia.
Yeah, about this whole thing kind of coming out now, Shimon, I mean, the Mueller investigation, it has been kept so quiet, what they have, what they don't have, where they're headed until now. How the New York Times describes kind of how this all came about, I thought was interesting, so I wanted to read it for everybody. According to the New York Times, when they wrote about this, this is, according to questions read by the special counsel investigators to the president's lawyers who compiled them into a list, that document was provided to the Times by a person outside of Mr. Trump's legal team. So where does this come from then?
It's a good question. You know, the Mueller team is pretty tight, and I know just and haven't spent, you know, over a year now reporting
exactly.
This. But we know based on some of our reporting that when the teams met, when the Mueller team and the Trump team met to discuss about possible interview, they gave them buckets sort of topics. And this, our understanding is that this came up, so a lot of these came up as in topics, and then that the president's legal team then decided to kind of, with the special counsel, craft some of these questions. But I just want to touch on something about Paul Manafort, because I think this is important, this question about collusion and whether this outreach. Manafort is a very central figure in this entire investigation, and in many ways it's why there's been so much pressure on him with these charges by the special counsel. In the end, it is everyone's belief that they want Paul Manafort to cooperate in this investigation for this very reason. Mm-hmm. There is intelligence, that was gathered by investigators that indicated that Paul Manafort, and we've done this reporting, either was communicating or there was outreach or there was something between Paul Manafort and people with connections to the Russians. And that has always, we believe, been a concern for the special counsel. And I think, quite frankly, they want to know more, more about that. And we've been doing a lot of reporting on that. And it shows you that really Manafort is a central figure in this investigation because of his extensive ties, really, to the Russians in the end. And he was the chairman of the campaign here at one point.
That's exactly right, even though they like to downplay how long he was with the campaign and his role. Mimi, you're kind of getting to this. When you take kind of the totality and the theme and how the questions are crafted in what you're looking at here, what does it tell you anything about exactly what Bob Mueller is looking for from the president? Does it tell you anything about what they might have already concluded?
Well, a couple of things. First of all, I don't know that Mueller crafted these questions, right? I mean, this is
also
what,
that's actually
and
important.
I think that's important. He probably gave topics and
they
the lawyer
the
wrote the questions. But yes, the information in the topics and the questions tells me that he's trying to get at what Donald Trump knew about actions and words and things that other people did. And it sounds like he has, I mean, this is reading tea leaves, and, you know, I could regret saying this later, but it sounds like he has or is concluding things about things that other people have done. And see, I think Trump doesn't understand conspiracy law because he's saying, oh, this isn't about me, basically, you know, no collusion. But in fact, the way the law works is if you knew that other people did things and you in any way, you know, facilitated it, knowing that that was going on, even if it's a small act, you know, you can be part of that conspiracy. And so I think it's very interesting that even though what he's constantly, these questions are constantly geared toward, you know, what did you know about Manafort? What did you know about Kushner's actions? But that's important. And that's exactly what a prosecutor, you know, wants to get at and know about his knowledge.
And about the timing right now, Asha, I mean, there's 49 questions. These leak out now. The question, this all is ahead of, is Donald Trump going to sit down with Bob Mueller's team? Will he face Bob Mueller? After seeing these questions published, do you think there's any chance that he will?
If his lawyers are smart, they will not let him sit for an interview. I think this covers so much ground. So much of it actually goes to not just what other people did, but his own tweets, his own interviews, his own words, his own actions that can really get him into trouble because it's his own motive that will determine whether he obstructed justice. You know, I think that we kind of don't really have a good place to go because if he doesn't sit down for the interview, then we start entering into uncharted constitutional territory where Mueller would have to issue a grand jury subpoena, and then there might be a standoff and possible litigation. So at this point,
so
it's anyone's
shrug
call
your shoulders
you know
and,
that there are twists and turns.
So it's just a shoulder shrug is how we're ending this one. But Asha, Mimi, Shimon, thank you guys very much. I really appreciate it. A lot to dig through in what we've just learned. Coming up, he says he didn't call the president an idiot, but reports in